Hello everyone, welcome to my channel and thank you for watching me. My name is Valeria and it's been a while since I posted my last video, but I had a really good reason for that. I was finishing my senior year in college and finally I'm done and here I am. So let's begin. This time I didn't concentrate my attention on regular stocks, I picked ETFs. And I know that it's more risky, but I don't have a problem with that. And also I want to tell you that I'm just a beginner, I'm not like professional stock investor or something. I invested in DGAS and UGAS, mostly in DGAS. These are ETFs, and DGAS is inverse velocity shares of natural gas. So let's say natural gas goes down for 1% today, and DGAS gonna go up. But you have to multiply that 1% by 3 because that's how DGAS works. And the same thing happens with UGAS. If regular natural gas goes down, the stock price of UGAS goes down as well, multiplied by 3. They are not for long-term period. You have to day trade them. That's the whole point of ETFs. Stock split happens in case when the company decides that ETF's price per share is too low, and usually it happens every year. I believe that the company provides information about that they're gonna make a stock split in advance in 2 weeks. Most likely it's gonna be reverse stock split 1 to 10. That means that for every 10 shares you're gonna get only one share. That is why it is very risky, because ETFs decay over time and you have to manage your risks. I strongly believe that the price of natural gas gonna go up again because the economy reopening again. And I would like to share with you my screen where I'm gonna tell you all my entries and exits, what I did since middle of April. You're gonna see that I didn't really make a lot of trades, but it made me a lot of money, starting from as little as $3,000, and it is really amazing. I still can't believe in this. Here, all my transactions began from April 8th, and I had traded some of regular stocks as ELF, IBM, Cola, Fizz, Starbucks, Ford, and my most concentration was on natural gas ETFs. So in April I had only 5 of trades, and during May I had 9 trades of natural gas, which brought me to very good return. I believe during April I got 2,100, and during May I got $3,700, which is for a beginner just awesome. Here is my Robinhood account. It's $10,000 right now. Why it's not 11,400? Because I have unrealized loss of my position of $400, and I transferred 1,000 to my regular account. That is why it's not $11,400. Also, I want to share some websites with you. I'm gonna post the link links below the video later. This is a weekly natural gas storage report. I made a huge mistake buying ETF of UGAS before this weekly report came out on Thursday, and usually it comes out 1 hour after market is opened at 10:30. And this time the net change was 109. That means that there is no demand and it's not good. Another website is YCharts. It shows natural gas rig count on Friday. There were good news about rig count. It decreased from 79 to 77. This is natural gas price. It's 184 right now. Website is very good. It's called TradingView, and it shows you very important information if you know how to apply indicators. Here are all indicators, it's a bunch of them, but since I'm new to this, I'm not really familiar with all of these indicators and I'm still learning. I already know about RCI indicator. It shows you when the stock is overbought and oversold. When the line goes up more than 80 points, it means that stock is overbought. That means that it's better to sell off your position, and it's oversold when it goes below 30 points. I want to mention one thing about day trading on Robinhood. You are allowed to make only 3 day trades during 5 day period. If you go to 4th day, you're gonna be marked as pattern day trader. That means you can only buy and sell one particular stock 3 times during 5 day period. And if you are marked as a pattern day trader, you're gonna be able to day trade only if you have 25,000 on your account. It's not a problem for me because I'm trying to keep it low. I don't really trade every day, so I never had a problem with that. I didn't have prior experience before starting to invest in ETFs or regular stocks, and I believe if you are watching this video right now and thinking about investing in ETFs, try to learn before you invest, because you can learn something out of my mistakes or my experience, and you're not gonna repeat that mistakes because you're gonna be informed on time. And I want to thank you as well again for watching me. If you like the video, crush that like button and subscribe for my channel for more videos. I'm gonna try to post 1 or 2 videos during the week. I'm gonna share with you what's going on with my portfolio, how it goes up or down, and I think it will be very interesting if you're just trying to learn. So thank you very much and see you next time.